Greetings, everybody, and welcome to episode 64 of the Heavy NFLD official podcast. Now, I know what you're thinking. Where the hell has this episode been? Yes, I acknowledge that. It's been a few months since I did the last installment of this podcast. I had a bunch of stuff happen in my life. Went on tour a bunch of times, had a bunch of shows happening. I've just been working pretty much nonstop since February. So, yeah, it's been hard to try and keep up with this podcast. But we're back, and I'm going to try and make up for the last several months, starting with March, where I usually do the recap for the Record Production Month Challenge, which happens in February and has the finishing date of March 1st. So, on this episode, we're going to go back and recount all the heavy, weird, experimental, punk releases that came out of the RPM Challenge this year, starting with what is probably my favorite one that emerged from this year, this project Elder Caius, which has done work for the RPM Challenge before in previous years. They released a new single this year called Super Destroyer, and it is awesome. It's just like a long progressive metal epic with a lot of spaciness going on, a lot of really, really great riffs. It's an instrumental track. Check it out. We're going to play that right now. This is Super Destroyer by Elder Caius.
We'll be right back. sacrifice to beat the war machine. The truth obscured, wrapped up in a tattered flag, unseen.
Of anguish, stand.
Okay, so what you just heard was Super Destroyer by Elder Caius starting things off. And how about those riffs, man? Like, there are some really, really good stoner doom metal riffs in amongst that. And then there's just that black metal section right there in the middle. Oh, it's just so good. And that was followed by In Flesh and Bone by Personal Space Invaders, the solo project of multi-instrumentalist Brian Downton. Brian's been doing the RPM challenge for years now. Like, I don't even understand how this guy manages to put out the kind of output that he does, but it's pretty impressive. He released an album this year called Random Voices AI Choices, I think, or Random Choices AI Voices, something like that. I always get the two mixed up. But it's pretty cool. It's got an interesting mixture of metal, punk, jazz, experimental music, ambient. It's just a whole bunch of different stuff always thrown together like that. And that was followed by a song called Meeting by a new project called Qloi from their first demo, the Tuvok demos. And this is a brand new noise ambient drone project from Tony Daw, which is pretty cool. They've released a bunch of demos after this one, so there's a lot to sift through there. Coming up next, we have another new project that emerged from the RPM Challenge this year. It's called The Ram Has Touched the Wall, which is a brand new melodic and blackened death metal project. So we're going to play a song called In the Arms of Death, which is the title track from the band's first EP released for RPM Challenge this year. Once again, that's In the Arms of Death by The Ram Has Touched the Wall.
Thank you.
Okay, what you just heard was In the Arms of Death by The Ram Has Touched the Wall, and that was followed by a song called Waves by an artist named Corsica. Corsica released their very first EP through the RPM Challenge. It is also called Waves, and as you heard through that song, it's kind of a guitar-centric, sort of proggy, instrumental rock music. I really like it. I think it's super smooth, super groovy, definitely worth checking out. Coming up next, we're going to take things into a bit more of a chaotic direction by featuring a band called Monroe with their brand new EP entitled Repeating Perfect Movements. The title there, obviously a reference to the RPM Challenge itself. And we're going to play a song from that called Not Working, once again by the band Monroe. We'll be right back. Okay, what you just heard was Monroe with Not Working, and that was followed by a song called Deep Water Ocean by an artist named Bodydouble, that's Bodydouble, all one word, from their album Lullabies for an Anxious Mind. This is a brand new ambient drone project from St. John's, and this is their very first album. So if you like that kind of music, definitely go check that out. Coming up next, we have a project that is very familiar to those who have been keeping up with the Record Production Month Challenge, and that's Count Cromulent, the Simpsons-themed progressive rock, space rock, psych rock, progressive electronic project that has released, at this point, I believe, 5 albums. So this year, being no different, they of course release yet another record entitled Monorail, and we're going to play a song from that. It's called A Brief History of Urban Planning and Civics.
Service between larger suburban centers and downtown Springfield. contract is awarded to Lanley Industrial. Experts warn that the development will divert funds from an already crumbling and underserved inner city, but their warnings are largely ignored. They build monorails at Brockway, Ogdenville, North Haverbrook, and by gum, it put them on the map.
Thank you. you are left in the place. These states have been destroyed. Each of them you got a boy. Falling out from different ripples, not knowing which side was at fault. Does he survive? We don't need you. It's time for the cycle to begin anew.
Okay, what you just heard was A Brief History of Urban Planning and Civics by Count Cromulent. That was followed up by My Least Favorite Things by Killer 9000, the band's most recent single, which, I will say, sounds a lot different than the stuff they put out before then. It's mostly just a silly little noise track compared to the more avant-garde jazzcore style of stuff that they normally do, so don't let that color your perspective of what this band does. This was more of just like a one-off, different experimental thing from the sounds of it. And that was followed by a song called War Never Changes by Securitron, which is my personal RPM installment this year. It is a Fallout-themed thrash metal record, so if that sounds like it's up your alley, then definitely go and check that out on Bandcamp and YouTube. But yeah, that's going to complete this installment of the Heavy NFLD official podcast, episode 64 for March 2024, the RPM Recap 2024. Stay tuned, because we are going to do a few more episodes over the course of this week to try and catch up to July. I hope you've enjoyed this installment, and I will see you in the next one. Until then, peace out and stay fucking heavy.